So today I'm going to share 5 things that I wish I knew before becoming an electrical engineer. Make sure you stay to the very end of the video to get the overall value, especially if this is something you're seriously thinking about. Hello everybody, my name is Jodabeni and I'm an electrical engineer and I'm based in the United States of America. And I currently live in the East Coast, so this is my perspective from the companies that are on this side of the USA. So I'm currently in the defense industry, so if that's an area that you're interested in, if you're interested in the military and things that related to the defense, yeah, so this is even better for you because this is coming straight from somebody who's in it. So let's get started with these 5 things that I wish I knew. So starting off, number 1, coding skills are essential for electrical engineers. So while circuits and mathematics are very fundamental to becoming an electrical engineer, you must be very diverse when it comes to programming, at least in MATLAB. So for most of electrical engineers going into the field, you're gonna be dealt with a lot of MATLAB, sometimes even Python. I've seen a lot of people doing C#, but majority of the time, you gotta be proficient in MATLAB. So when it comes to electrical engineers or a hardware engineer as I am, a lot of the testing that we do on a lot of the equipment is done through MATLAB. It does a lot of data analysis and all these things that we manage our hardware with is used in MATLAB. Yes, software engineers are more flexible in what coding languages that they can use, but specifically towards you when you're working with hardware directly, the number one thing as an electrical engineer you're going to run into is MATLAB. So if you don't have your MATLAB skills up to par, and especially if you're still in college or you're thinking about switching over from software engineer, make sure your MATLAB skills are top notch because it'll just make your life so much easier down the line. So the second thing that you need to pay attention to if you're trying to go into the electrical engineering side of things is consider a work-life balance before choosing a career path. So if you're a workaholic and you love being on site and you love just getting into the dirty dirt of electrical engineering with hands-on, cool. Make sure you focus your college courses and your experience that you get during college towards that, because currently my position is hybrid. So I can be 50% on site, 50% at home. And a majority of the time I'm on site when it comes to testing, when it comes to certain meetings that I have to be in person, but everything else, because of what I do, a lot of it is done on the computer itself. So I don't necessarily need to be in the office physically. So although I'm not coding as much as a software engineer, but all the circuitry and if you have to use Cadence, if you have to use CSC, if you have to use any of these electrical engineering softwares, a lot of the times you don't need to be physically there in the company. So think hard on how you want your career to be. If you want to be in the on-site testing and working on hardware itself, make sure the classes you take in college or the experience you get correlates to that so that you can get those positions. But if you're a type of person that likes to stay at home and you don't like to talk to people, you don't even want to see them, right? Then make sure you tailor your resume with courses and experience that will allow you to be more remote than in person. So take those electives that if you actually got on the field, you wouldn't have to see people. I don't mind seeing people at all, but sometimes it saves you money when you don't have to drive 30 minutes to work twice every day because it adds up. So the third big thing that I think everybody needs to understand is that the amount of math you're going to do in college will not correlate what you do in the work field. So the way math was stressing me out in college, because you have to go calculus 1, 2, and 3, you got to go to differential equations, and all this math will have you thinking to yourself, man, if I'm struggling in differential equations, is it gonna make it harder for me to get a job? Is it gonna make it harder for me to be on site? You'll be fine. I promise you, you'll be fine, right? A lot of these math problems that you do learn, you may not even use, you're gonna lose maybe less than 10% of it. But there are those jobs that are strictly goes down deep and dirty into those math equations. And before they hire you, they're gonna vet you with certain questions during your interview. So you would already be prepared if you're not gonna be doing that, or you will. But for the most part, don't stress yourself too much about all the math that you're given. Just make sure you pass those courses with a good grade. And if you hate math, you never have to touch math, okay? Just remember that. If you hate math, you never have to touch it. So get to those courses, get your degree, and whenever you come out, go into an area where you won't have to use math as much. I have friends who are electrical engineers and they have not touched a single circuit problem in their whole career in the past 3 years. They just do testing, they just know MATLAB, and that's their whole career. The fourth thing, if I knew this, because currently I'm in the military, I'm in the National Guard Reserves. So I go to training once a month and I am a military personnel. And here's the catch, they cover all of my student loans. The amount of times I was hungry in college, looking back, I'm like, man, if I would have known I was gonna join the military, because they give you up to $50,000 that they'll pay off your student loans on your first contract. I had $20,000 with those student loans, and that was me paying out of pocket for the rest of it, okay? If I would have known I was gonna join the military, I would have 100% got more student loans. Wanna know why? Because it was gonna be covered by the military, and I wouldn't have to work part-time during college to help my GPA. Life would have been completely different if I knew that was a pathway that I was gonna do. I know it's not for everybody, but looking at the economy now in society, getting rid of your student loans 100% will make a big difference in your career down the line. And at the same time, you get to serve your country and you defend your family and you protect them. So it's always a plus. This isn't sponsored by the Army, by the way. If they did, it would be nice, but knowing the Army, they're not gonna sponsor this video. And the fifth thing I would wanna, you know, make sure is the most important thing in this video, right? It's one of the most important things is you have to make sure the electives you pick are tailored to what you wanna do in the real world. Because a lot of the time, the current job that I have, the reason why I received it is because there are certain classes that I took as an elective, right? In my class, there was only 8 of us who took that course, but I graduated and less than a month, I got a job offer because of a certain skill that I learned through that class. I remember the first day of class, our professor was telling us, hey, we're learning metamaterials. If you don't know what that is, Google it. It's related to RF manipulation. Metamaterials is a new thing. There was 8 people in our class. I took it, I learned it. I made a patch in 10, I learned about metamaterials, and boom, I put that on my resume, and that was the first thing people would ask me about. Because even the interviewers, other engineers are curious about that topic title, and you're somebody who's coming out of college who's received an education behind it, and it puts you ahead of the ball game. So tailor your electives towards something you wanna do in the future, not just because you think it's cool, but because you know that this class you're going to take is gonna give you an advantage over your competitors. Getting an engineering degree is hard. Some people will tell you it's not, they're capping, it's hard. But the fruit at the end of it, it's so much worth it. I don't even know how many times I thought about changing majors, dropping out. It goes through, that thought will cross your mind at least once. It happens to every college student. Doesn't matter what degree you get tempted with thoughts of, hey, maybe I could do something else. But I promise you, once you finish and you get that first paycheck, there's no going back. Like, there's absolutely no going back. The only other thing you can go for is a master's. You only go forward. So take that how you will, and God bless you. And if you have any questions for me, maybe, hey, let me know in the comment section down below. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button and the like button if you found value in this video. And I really do appreciate you all that came and stayed. Thank you, and Jodabeni is